हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास फिफ्थ स्टूडेंट, आई वेलकम यू टू दिस ऑनलाइन क्लास. स्टूडेंट, एज वी हैड रेड दिस पोएम इन आवर प्रीवियस ऑनलाइन क्लास, बट सम चिल्ड्रन हैड डिफ़िकल्टी विद इट्स रीडिंग. सो आई विल रीड दिस पोएम अगेन. आई विल रीड दिस पोएम ट्वाइस. फर्स्ट आई विल रीड द पोएम स्लोली एंड देन आई विल रीड दिस पोएम फास्ट. And in between these two reading, I will explain the difficult words, and after that we will do the back exercise of this chapter. Let's start its reading. From the Railway Carriage, a beautiful poem by Robert Louis Stevenson. Faster than fairies, faster than witches, bridges and houses, hedges and ditches, and charging along like troop in a battle, all through the meadows the horses and cattle, all of the sides of the hill and the plain, fly as thick as driving rain, and even again in the wink of an eye, painted station whistle by. Here is a child who clamber and scrambles. Here is a tramp who stands and gazes. And here is a green for stringing the daisies. Here is a cart run away on the road, lamping alone with a man and load. And here is a mill, and there is a river, each a glimpse and gone forever. Students, these are the difficult words of the chapter. From the Railway Carriage. View, scene, passing, disappearing, hedges, borderline made out of bushes or shrubs. I will show you its picture. See this picture. These border lines are called hedges. Carriage, room in a train. Look at this picture. This is railway carriage. CARRIAGE, carriage. This is the picture of carriage, railway carriage. A room in a train. Witches, ugly woman having magic. See this picture. This is the picture of which. Witches mean ugly woman having magic. Next, ditches. This type of place where water run off. This type of low place where water run off. This is called ditch, D-I-T-C-H, ditch. The poet saw these kind of things when he traveling in a railway carriage. Next, charging, quickly goes forward, meadows, grassy field. This and this types of grassy field are called meadows, MEEDOWS, meadows. The poet sees these type of meadows when he is traveling in a railway carriage. Next, sight means vision, seeing. Driving rain, heavy and blowing rain as in storm. Next, wink of an eye, close and open an eye quickly. That is called wink of eye, means close and open of eye quickly. Clamber, to move by using both hand and feet with difficulty. Tramp, a poor person. Gaze, to look in one direction for a long time. Stringing the daisies, it means making chain with the daisies flower. Cart means vehicle with two or four wheels that is pulled, that is used to pulled by a horse. Vehicle with two or four wheels that is pulled by a horse. Next, lumping. Lumping means take. Yes, students, now I will read the poem fast. Faster than fairies, faster than witches, bridges and houses, hedges and ditches, and charging along like a troop in a battle, all through the meadows, the horses and cattle. All of the sides of the hill and plain fly as thick as driving rain, and ever again in the wink of an eye, painted station whistle by. Here is a child who clamber and sclamber, here is a tramp who stands and gazes, and here is a green for stringing the daisies. Here is a cart run away on the road, lumping along with man and load. And here is a mill and there is a river, each in a glimpse and gone forever. Dear students, for more explanation of this poem, I will show you the explanation of this poem in Hindi. I hope you can read that yourself. Students, this is all the explanation of this poem in Hindi. You can take help from here for more understanding of this poem. Read it yourself. And now we will solve the back exercise of this chapter. Students, this is the solution. I make some notes. Watch it. You can do solve your back exercise with the help of it. And here I would like you explain present perfect tense in the back exercise of this chapter. Present perfect tense. Students, there is a very simple rule for the present perfect tense. That is this one. You have to follow this rule for making sentence in present perfect tense. We use present perfect tense to show an action that has been completed in recent time. Like, I have done my homework. He has gone to Delhi. In these sentences, what is the rule? We can use has, have, past participle form of the verb. Past participle form of the verb means third form of the verb. You have to use third form of the verb in present perfect tense with has or have. We use have with plural and has with singular. And with I, we always use have, like I have. We never use has with I.
we always use have the plural with I, and with the subject we with it we all with it we use have, have, have means with I and we you have to use have. And according to this sentence, sorry, according to this tense, what is the rule? The main rule is using, you have to use has, have, and plus past participle form of the verb. Like done, done is the past participle form of the verb. Like gone, eaten means third form of the verb. Here are some sentences given related to present perfect tense. So you have to solve some exercises of this chapter. Exercise B and C related to present perfect tense. Means you have to use has or have plus third form of the verb in this. Fill up. The form, simple forms are given here in bracket. You have to change these all into third form, and you have to use these with has or have. And this is also related to present perfect tense. You have to solve it. I already provided you the notes related to this. You can do solve it from there. And the next one, here is creative writing. Creative writing, you have to write a scene on a railway station. It's all, solution is also there. I provided you, and do solve these exercise, all exercise, and students solve the question answer on your notebook, and the remaining exercise on your workbook. I hope you understand all this, and after completing all the work related to back exercise, students, please message me that ma'am, I have done my homework, okay, on YouTube, and comment me that you have done your homework. Okay, students, thank you, students. For any query, you can also message me, and thank you so much, students. Have a nice day.